Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of MongoDB, that is version 7, on a Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily create your database, then collection, and how you can easily insert data in our MongoDB. So do watch the video till the end. If you like this video, please give it a like and also do subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. And if you face any issues in middle, please put a comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. So let's start our video. Now to install MongoDB on your Windows operating system, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and in the address bar, just simply search with MongoDB download and hit enter. And this will show you this MongoDB community server download link. So just simply click on this link and it's going to redirect to the official site of MongoDB. And here you can see we have MongoDB community server download. So this link I'm going to put in the description so you can directly navigate to this site by just simply clicking on this link. All right. So now if you just simply scroll down, here you can see that our latest version of MongoDB is version 7 is rightly available to download. And if you want to download any older version, you need to click on this drop down and you can select older version from here. That I am not going to show you in this video. I am going to select version 7, and operating system is currently Windows x64. If you want to use any other operating system like Linux, macOS, or any other operating system, you can subsequently select it from this drop down. And packages MSI, that is Microsoft installer, I'm going to again keep this default. I don't want to download any zip. It's going to be a direct MSI. Okay, so just simply click on this download button and it's going to start downloading our MongoDB. All right, I have already downloaded it, so I'll just simply cancel it. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and here you can see we have already MongoDB available. Okay, so if you see the file size is 570 MB. All right, and this is our installer. So just simply double click on the installer and you can minimize your download directory, and here you can see we have MongoDB version 7 installation wizard is rightly opened over here. So just simply click on next over here, and these are license agreement. You need to accept this license agreement and then you need to click on next. And now it is asking whether you'd like to install a complete version of MongoDB or you want to custom installation. I'll be recommending you to install the complete version of the MongoDB, but in that case it requires more disk space, so that you need to be aware about. And otherwise you can go for custom installation also, so it totally depends upon you. I'm going to choose complete, and as soon as you click that, it will show you this server configuration page. So here if you see, it is telling install MongoDB as a server, so that's a very important thing. So what it happens is, you probably heard about these services. So if you search about services, it will show you this list of services. So these are a list all of all services. So here it's going to install a new service which will be naming as MongoDB. So that's why this checkbox and all other things like service name and where our data is going to be installed, what will be our log directory. So everything they have set it properly over here. All you need to do is click on next. And it also asking whether you'd like to use MongoDB Compose. So install MongoDB Compose is checked. So what is MongoDB Compose is, it will give you a, you know, graphic user interface. So the, right on that application, you can perform your all this card operation right there. All right. So it's going to, you know, give you a very good user interface. So do install MongoDB Compose as well. Okay. Now just simply click on next. And it's ready to be installed. Click on install and there you go. You can see our installation has rightly started. Before that, it will ask you for administrative privileges. You need to just simply click on yes and our installation has rightly begun. So this will take a couple of minutes. After that, I'm going to again come back to this video. And you can see that our MongoDB is rightly started initializing, and there you go. You can see completed the MongoDB version 7. All right, so you can just simply click on finish and you can see this welcome to Compose message. So you can just simply click on start, and this is our MongoDB Compose rightly opened over here. So you can maximize this. So this is the interface of our MongoDB Compose. So here you can see we have the URL. So this is our port number and this is our localhost domain. So this port number is very important when you are establishing the connection with your backend code with your database. So this port number is very important. Alright, so you know, now you can just simply click on this connect, and here you can see we have these, you know, instructions coming out from this database link. So you can just simply click on got it and you can click on this database. So here you can create your database. So let's give the database name as test db. Alright, and you can name your collection name here as well. So let's give the collection name as players. Alright, and then you can just simply click on this create database and it's going to start creating your database. So here you can see our test db.players has been rightly created. So test db is the name of our database and players is our, you know, collection name. So from here, if you want to, you know, import any data, you can just simply click on this import data and you can, you know, choose any JSON or CSV file and browse it from your, you know, laptop or desktop. That you can do. Or else if you want to create any data, you can, that also you can do. Just simply click on this, you know, add data and click on insert document. So this will open this insert document window. Here you need to click on this hamburger icon and you can click on this plus icon to click on this add field after ID, and here you can provide the ID, like let's give name and give the player name as Shourav. Okay, you can click on simply insert and here you can see that our data is rightly inserted over here. Alright, so here if you hover over, you can see we have this edit document icons. If you click on this, and you can edit your name right over here. Alright, I'm going to click on cancel now. If you want to, you know, copy this document, you can just simply copy it and you can paste this entire thing in any notepad or in your code as well, whatever. Okay, then here is our clone document. So if you click on this, it will show you whether you like to clone that exact same thing. If you hit insert, it's going to clone that exact same thing over here. Okay, and here is our delete button. So if you want to delete this, it will going to be deleted. All right. So in this, you can easily create your database, create your collection, and so on our MongoDB. If you want to create one more database, you can click on this and you can again create your database. All right. So if you need a more detailed video, like how to use MongoDB console, so for that, I have already made a detailed video on that. So I'll be putting that link in the description. Do watch that video as well if you want to know more about MongoDB console. All right. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, please give it a like and also do subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.